Welcome to Nugget 200 with Steve Grohman. This nugget will be a recap of nuggets 155 through 199. We do put a lot of research and effort into these nuggets to help you and your family grow in the truth of creation and in God's Word, and we hope that you share them with your friends and family. If you can help us by partnering with us on a monthly basis or a one-time basis, we certainly appreciate it. As many of you know, we have had a tremendous amount of mechanical issues. Not to mention that our windshield in the Tahoe got just annihilated by a big stone from an oil tanker as Steve was going to go get the welding work done. And we also had to get front brakes on the motorhome. A lot of this stuff is just normal maintenance on it, just it's all come at the same time has been almost devastating. And we do not have the meetings that we usually have. We are working on about a third of the meetings that we normally have annually. We want to tell you about our website. It's creationseminar.net. Our phone number is 603-616-8907. Feel free to call or text. And we do have a donation page. It's https://creationseminar.net/donate.htm. And if you go to Facebook, you can follow us there. We post all of our nuggets and the Saturday history and travel tips on our Facebook page, A Creation Seminar. Many of you watch us on our YouTube channel. It's simply Steve Grohman. Like, subscribe, and don't forget to hit the notification bell to be alerted when we post new nuggets and Saturday history and travel tips. And please share these with your friends. We take Zelle and PayPal. So if you use those methods of payment, you simply use creation_seminar@creationseminar.net. And Steve is available for a thought-provoking interview on your YouTube channel. Many of you probably have YouTube channels. It's become sort of the thing to do these days, or a podcast, or if you know of a radio station in your area that would interview him. We don't have to be going there. Just a lot of times the radio stations are looking for hot topics, and creation versus evolution certainly is one of those. Or if we are in your area, if there is a local television program that can have us, again, contact us at 603-616-8907. Creation versus evolution is incredibly important. As Steve says in the meetings, there either is a God or there isn't. And there is. And he is the creator. And we need to learn as much about him and respect and understand his creation. We have 12 lessons in the seminar series. Lesson 1, why is this important? Lesson 2, Bible or billions? Lesson 3, Noah's big boat. A lot of things about Noah's Ark and the flood that you probably didn't notice as you were reading through it in the Bible. Lesson 4 is after the flood. Lesson 5, misconceptions about space. Why is it that if NASA says it, we believe it? Lesson 6, all about dinosaurs. Lesson 7, words mean things, and words do mean things. What does prehistoric mean, and when did that word come about? What does the word dinosaur mean, and what does the word day mean? Critical words are dissected, and many common words that we use are broken down in this lesson. Lesson 8, Darwin's legacy. An incredibly important, riveting lesson. Lesson 9, rock solid proof. Do the rocks prove evolution, or do they prove a great flood? Lesson 10, living proof. 3 hours worth of information about how plants, animals, dinosaurs, and even people prove a creator, a designer. Lessons in 6 days. What did God do on those 6 days? And who are those theologians, unbelievably, that compromised the Word of God and brought in false science into the Bible and have swayed many, many people that are Christians to believe in evolution? And then lesson 12 is question and answers. Where we wrap up things that weren't a part of the other 11 lessons, like Pangaea, macro, microevolution. When was the ice age? What about the mammoths? All 12 lessons are $180 and $10 shipping and handling. It's a great investment. And as this says, these God-honoring lessons need to be a part of every home's video library. Again, I hope you watch the Saturday Travel and History Tips. And at this time, we are traveling northward on U.S. Highway 83 and presenting all the fun, often on the beaten path, sites along this highway to nowhere. It actually spans from South Padre Island to the Canadian-North Dakota border. Back to the point of this nugget, what have we covered lately? In Nuggets 155 through 157, we took you to Ringing Rocks, part of the Bucks County Park System. In these nuggets, you will hear about these rocks, see them sing, and explore the park with us. The Lord said that even the rocks will cry out if we don't. Nuggets 158 and 159, we took you to the Petrified Forest National Park on the eastern side of Arizona. This is a gorgeous park, and we have been there several times. These petrified trees and logs prove a rapid flood. In Nuggets 160 through 163, we talk about the U.S. Geological Survey and how a lot of our nation was mapped apt, and we have a lovely interview with a delightful man who is a retired surveyor from the USGS, and we focus in on his interviews on Nuggets 162 and 163. His stories of traveling the United States and hanging out in a lot of swamps is humorous and informative. In Nugget 164, we take you to Capulin Volcano in northeast New Mexico. It's sort of an out-of-the-way place, but this national monument is one of the best places to walk the rim of a volcano and actually walk into the center of the volcano. In Nuggets 165 through 167, we interviewed a New York State Forest Ranger. Wayne was so informative and enlightening about the Forest Service and the dangerous forest fires. And we take you on several personal encounters with fire, but this interview with Ranger Wayne is extremely interesting. In Nuggets 168 through 170, we talk about misinformation and we review several articles in the Science News, May 2021 magazine, and just exposing the bias that is presented. Who determines if something is misinformation? In Nugget 170 of this series, we tell you of a personal story of a student in Plymouth, Massachusetts that was changed forever when he found out the truth of his textbooks, how he was devastated by what his teacher had to say. In Nugget 171, we talk about Neanderthals and how Neanderthals and humans mated. I don't think so, but learn how the evolutionists are sure that they did. In Nugget 172, we review an article called Human-Like Brains Had a Late Start. Does the size of your brain determine your intelligence? I don't think so. You will want to watch Nugget 172 and hear what they say and how we counter their argument. In Nugget 173, we go through a specific science news magazine. This magazine is targeted towards high school students to encourage them to enter STEM. What's STEM? Well, you'll have to watch the Nugget to know. This particular magazine had an advertisement from a university on almost every other page, and it's mind-boggling, I'd say, the propaganda that they are using to lure children into this. If your children are interested in STEM, that's great, but make sure that they are grounded in the Word of God and creation. In Nugget 174, we take you to a gigantic boulder hidden away in a tiny town in northern New Hampshire. Although we have scoured almost every mile of New Hampshire, I don't know how we missed this big boy. And you'll want to watch this fun nugget. And actually, after doing it, we had many friends that live in New Hampshire make the trek to go see this enormous boulder. In Nuggets 175 through 177, we interviewed our friend of a quarter of a century, David Clifford. David is a machinist, and we want you to know, what is a machinist and how important are they? He works for the Mount Washington Cog Railway in northern New Hampshire. These beautiful old steam trains and now diesel trains make the trek up to Mount Washington daily, and you will want to listen to our interviews with David Clifford as he shows us old school equipment and new equipment that is used to maintain these marvelous pieces of equipment. In Nugget 178, we review an article where evolutionists claim that life came from a space rock. You'll have to listen to this nugget to see where the space rock was, where it came from, and how evolutionists believe that life came from a space rock. We know that life came from God. God is the only one that can give life, not an outer space rock. In Nugget 179, we talk about dark energy and dark matter. It could just as well be called Fred and Wilma, according to Neil deGrasse Tyson. You'll want to listen to this nugget because many people are enamored by dark energy and dark matter. Hear the truth about what they know about dark energy and dark matter. You will be surprised. And then Nuggets 180 through 183 are what we call American Grit. In these four nuggets, we interviewed one of our greatest friends. His name is Joel White. He is an industrious, amazing, kind man. In Nugget 180, we'll take you hiking with him. In Nugget 181, he will talk about how he started driving a pumper truck while he was only a young teen. In Nugget 182, he will talk to you about his fireworks business. And in Nugget 183, we will take you to Ground Zero to a fireworks display on 4th of July. And you won't want to miss these because you have got to see the pictures of Joel's incredible house. In Nugget 184, we talk about the real Dilophosaurus. Probably not. restaurant. In Nugget 185, you will learn about umwawa. I bet you've all been waiting to learn about umwawa and pseudoscience. In Nugget 186, we talked about the Ice Age and how evolutionists are using Mars as an example. But we point out that here they have Mars as blue, and it was always known so far as the red planet. And you will want to notice the impact craters and what we point out about the impact craters. They're shown here on Mars, and whenever you look at the moon, you can see the craters. Very interesting. In Nugget 187, again, life from space. In Nugget 188, what happened to the ozone layer? Is it repaired? Why? How did it get messed up? Was it your fault? I don't think so. Remember when everything was just going to end because of the hole in the ozone? Well, what happened to the ozone layer? In Nugget 189, we start a series on mushrooms. Yes, those unlikely little guys that grow on the ground. In Nugget 189, we talk about a flower that mimics a mushroom. In Nuggets 190 and 191, we cover an article where a man believes that if astronauts just took mushrooms in space, everything would be so much better. And in these nuggets, you will enjoy some beautiful pictures of mushrooms that were taken by Bonnie White, Joel's wife, and by myself. In Nugget 192, we cooked up some mushrooms. Maybe you will want to follow this recipe. In Nugget 193, you will enjoy beautiful photographs of mushrooms throughout the Great North Woods. They're simply a sight to see. In Nugget 194, we go through an article where the evolutionists say that music evolved. Well, of course music had to evolve from their standpoint because they think everything evolved, but they can't figure out why. Well, music didn't evolve, and we know why we have music, and we give you the scriptural answers of why we have music. In Nugget 195, we talk about big insects. Why did they live? And you'll want to see the roaches. Well, maybe you won't, but go ahead, take a look. In Nugget 196, we discuss the scripture verses on everything that has breath praises the Lord. And then in 197, the earth is on fire. This is an article by a young man who only knows the tales of global warming and how he has been so indoctrinated is incredibly important. And we realize that there are so many people that were born in the 21st century now that are college age, and this is all they know. It's very eye-opening to understand his perspective. Nugget 198, ethics and meat. God said we could eat meat. You will hear in this nugget how in an ethics class, they tried to influence students to not eating meat. Were they successful? It was only one day in class, and they were greatly influenced. What do days and weeks and months and years in evolutionary settings do to your mindset? And then in Nugget 199, we go through an article on where scientists admit that you have values. I hope you have values, and I hope they're godly values. The scientists say that they need to appear more unbiased, or do they need to show and admit they have values? I think it's very clear what their values are. This is Nugget 200, a recap of the last group of nuggets. We want to encourage you to go back and watch them and share them with others. And not only this chunk, but this makes our 200th nugget. There is a ginormous, is that a real word? I don't know. It's going to work today. Amount of information in these nuggets. Please use them, share them, and we appreciate you. Again, this is a listener-supported ministry. Thank you.